हाँ, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. इन इन लास्ट लेक्चर, वेट फॉर 1 मिनट. हाँ, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सॉलिड सॉल्यूशंस एंड इट्स डिफरेंट टाइप्स. एंड आफ्टर दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ह्यूम रोथरीज रूल ऑफ सॉलिड सॉलिडिफिकेशन. नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द कूलिंग कर्व. And after that, we are going to discuss different types of the cooling curves. Okay, first I will explain you what is the meaning of the cooling curve. Whether my screen is clearly visible and whether my voice is clearly audible, please confirm it once so that I will continue then.
Yes, sir. It is clearly audible.
Clearly audible, na? Okay, no problem. And kindly, any one of you, please make one small video of that attendance. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay, no problem. And we will start then.
Okay.
Now, in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the what is the meaning of the cooling curve, and after that, we will discuss some different types of some four approximately four types of the cooling curves are there. And that cooling curve types we are going to deal here only. And in this today's lecture only, we are going to implement the we have in previous lectures we have discussed about the Gibbs phase rule. Now we are going to see how that Gibbs phase rule is practically used, or what is the use of that Gibbs phase rule in our metallurgy. Then first we will discuss with, what is the meaning of the cooling curve. Now here in the first line, you can clearly see in this slide, first point, cooling curve is a line graph that represents the change of phase of matter, typically from gas to a solid or a liquid to a solid. Now here, as far as our metallurgy is concerned, here we are going to deal with the a cooling curve which is obtained, or which will show the phase change when that particular, suppose we have taken one metal or alloy and we have heated that from the solid state to the liquid state. Now from that liquid state, that alloy will be, from that liquid state we are cooling that alloy to the solid. Now when we are doing the cooling from liquid to the solid, and there will be some phase changes will be there in that particular alloy, and if you plot a curve by taking temperature temperature as a function of time, then we will get a continuous curve. That continuous curve will be termed as the yes.
Due to some issue, you can again share the screen.
Again means it is visible, na?
No, sir. Some of the students have presented by mistake the screen, so it's not visible now.
Then what I have to do now?
Just stop sharing the screen and again share the screen.
Okay, okay. Wait, I will do that. Okay, whether it is visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, shall I continue then?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, I will repeat it now. What is the meaning of the cooling curve? Suppose you have taken one metal or one alloy. Now it will be, initially it will be in the solid state. Suppose you have provided some heat to that metal or alloy, it will get transformed to the liquid state. Now, from this liquid state, you have started cooling that metal or alloy. then from that liquid it will get transformed to the solid. During this process of transformation from liquid state to the solid state, if suppose you have plotted a curve by taking temperature as a function of time, means here we are going to take temperature on y-axis and time on x-axis, then you will get a continuous curve, and that curve will be termed as the cooling curve. Okay, then are you getting this? Here I have mentioned that the independent variable is time, and this independent variable time we are plotting it on the x-axis, and dependent variable here is the temperature, and that we are going to plot on the y-axis. Okay, then in our means, as far as our part is concerned, metallurgy part, means whichever part is we are having in our syllabus, here basically just we are going to use the only four types of the cooling curves. There are number of or different types of cooling curves are there, but as far as our means your third year syllabus is concerned, we are going to use these four curves only. That's why we are going to discuss only these four types of the cooling curves. There are number of types of the cooling curves available, but we are going to discuss only these four types of the cooling curves. Now, these four cooling curves will be like this. In the first slide, we will discuss about the cooling curve for the pure metal. Here, this is the cooling curve for that pure metal. Here, as it is a pure metal, the here composition will be 100%, only that metal will be present. But in actual practice, it is not possible to get the 100% pure metal. Purity will be 99.5 or 99.9, like this. It may, but as far as our theoretical part is concerned, here we are considering it as a 100% pure metal, means only one element will be here. Okay, please try to understand this. As it is a pure metal, only one element will be there. Means here, when we are going to use the Gibbs phase rule, that is P plus F is equal to C plus 1. Okay, we are going to use this equation, P plus F is equal to C plus 1. Then here, the value of the C for this cooling curve will be 1, as we are considering the pure metal. Number of components or number of elements will be 1 here throughout this curve for the pure metal. The cooling curve obtained for the pure metal is here shown in the slide. You can draw this, and region wise we are going to apply the Gibbs phase rule. Now here we are going to use the Gibbs phase rule to find out the degree of the freedom for each region. Now first of all, I will explain this curve, and after that we are going to apply the Gibbs phase rule part wise. Okay, that we'll discuss in the next half of the lecture. First, I will discuss about this curve. Okay, I will tell you the description of this curve. Here, this curve is obtained for the pure metal. Means how this curve is obtained? We have taken one pure metal. You can take any pure metal. Suppose you have taken iron, or you have taken gold, or you have taken silver, and you have heated it from the solid state to the liquid state. And from liquid state, you have cooled it to the solid. And while doing the cooling from liquid to the solid, you have plotted a curve by taking temperature as a function of time, means temperature on y-axis and time on the x-axis, then you will get this kind of the curve. Now, starting means from point A to B, you can clearly see here the point A. This is your point A, and this is the point B. In this region, from starting from point A to B, your metal will be in the liquid state. Here I have mentioned it. L means the liquid state or phase, liquid phase. In A to B region, your metal will be in the liquid state. And when that metal reaches at point B, freezing will start. Freezing is nothing but the solidification will start, and it will get completed at point C. Here, the freezing process is shown in a straight line, means this pure metal will solidify at a constant temperature. That's why you can say that any pure metal is having constant melting point temperature. Okay, because it is solidifying at a constant temperature. The freezing starts at point B and freezing will get completed at point C, and after point C up to point D, in this region CD, that your pure metal will be in the solid state only. Okay, so this is the description of this pure metal. Now here in region A to B, your metal is in liquid state. In region B to C, that metal is in liquid plus solid state. And below that point C, means in region C to D, your pure metal is in solid state only. Now here, this liquid state and solid state is nothing but the phase here. For each region, I have mentioned the phase. In A to B, here liquid phase is there, means value of P is equal to 1, as only one phase is there. Then in region B to C, liquid and solid, two phases are there. Then it means that here value of P is equal to 2. And from here C to D, here again only one phase is present there. It means that value of the P is again 1 in the region C to D. Now, we are going to find out, here we are going to find out for each region, means here three regions are here for the this total cooling curve, region AB, region BC and region CD. Now for each region, we are going to apply separately Gibbs phase rule, and we are going to find out the degrees of freedom for each region. Degrees of freedom is nothing but number of parameters which can be varied without changing the phase in that particular region. In suppose in AB region, if you are able to find out that Gibbs degrees of freedom, that degrees of freedom value will indicate, suppose here I got the value of is equal to 1. This 1 indicates here you can vary either temperature, and here no point in varying the composition, means composition will be fixed. Means you can vary only temperature without changing the phase. And in the BC region, here F is equal to 0, means you cannot vary the temperature. If you change the temperature, phase will get changed. Means again, or suppose you have increased the temperature, it will get transformed to the liquid phase. And if you have decreased the temperature, it will get transformed to the solid state, like this. And in a region C to D, here again F is equal to 1. This F is equal to 1 indicates that you can vary the temperature without changing the phase in this CD region. Now, first of all, we'll start according to the region. First, we will select this region AB, okay, A to B. Please concentrate here. Some equations are here. Please concentrate on my voice. I will tell you slowly. First, you have to write the Gibbs phase rule equation. You have to write like this, for region AB. First, we will apply for region AB. Okay, I will explain it slowly for this one region, so that you the same rule you have to apply it again and again. Only value of the phases will be different for each region. Okay, first is region AB. Region AB Gibbs phase rule for region AB. Then your equation is P plus F is equal to C plus 1. In this region AB, we are applying Gibbs phase rule. Gibbs phase rule is like this, P plus F is equal to C plus 1. Now, value of P for value of the C is 1 for all regions, as there is pure metal, only one component or one element will be there. Value of C is equal to 1. Okay, for all regions, value of C is confirmed. Just the value of P will be here varying. Okay, for this region AB, here phases are only one phase is there, that is metal is in liquid state. Your equation will be like this, P plus F is equal to C plus 1. Okay, this will be your initial equation. Now, here you have to put the value of P. As a single phase is there, P is equal to 1, then 1 plus F is equal to, here again value of C is 1, that is 1 plus 1, and you will get F is equal to 1. Okay, as F is equal to 1, it indicates that It is univariant system. This system will be termed as univariant system. As degree of freedom value is 1, it is univariant system. It means that you can vary that only one parameter, that is temperature, without changing the phase in the system. And it can be clearly understood from that graph. In region AB, for different temperature, phase will be same. In region AB, you can take any temperature point in region AB. At different temperatures, you will get the only one phase, that is the liquid phase. And it is indicated by this F is equal to 1. Now, we will move towards the next region, region BC. Here, again, you have to apply the Gibbs phase rule. That is P plus F is equal to C plus 1. Okay. Here, you have to put the value of P and C. C value is 1. Okay. As pure metal is there, value of C is equal to 1. Then value of P here in region BC, number of phases are 2. Two phases are present here, liquid plus solid, means your equation will become 2 plus F is equal to 1 plus 1. Okay, means in the next line you have to write F is equal to 0. As degree of freedom value is 0, this system will be termed as non-variant system or invariant system. I'll repeat this sentence again. As F value is equal to 0, that is degree of freedom value is 0, the system will be termed as invariant or non-variant system. And it indicates that you cannot change the temperature without changing the phase. If you change the temperature value here, there will be phase change. Means if you increase the temperature, that metal will get transformed to the liquid state. And if you suppose you have decreased the temperature value, then that metal will get transformed to the solid state. And in this region, straight line is there. Hello?
Sir, your voice is breaking.
Voice is?
Sir, can you please remove your headphones and speak?
Okay. Wait.
Voice is low here. Are you able to hear my voice now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, shall I continue then? It is clear, na?
Yes.
Okay. As you have, as you can see clearly here, that BC is a straight line. It indicates that the pure metal will get solidified at a constant temperature, which means that particularly the pure metals are having a constant melting point. Okay. So then you have to move towards the next region of this cooling curve, that is the region CD. Now for this region CD, you have to apply again Gibbs phase rule. You have to apply, that is P plus F is equal to C plus 1. Then here the number of phases are only 1 here. Number of phases, only 1 phase is here. Number of elements are, again number of element is only 1, as pure metal is here. Then that equation will be like this. 1 plus F is equal to 1 plus 1. And it will get the value, it will give the value of F is equal to 1, means degree of freedom value is 1. It means that it is a univariant system. And as it is a univariant system, it will indicate that you can vary only one parameter, that is the temperature, without changing the phase of the system. And it can be clearly observed from the this line CD. Can clearly see here that whatever may be the temperature in this region, only one phase is there, and that phase is the solid phase only. And this is the total explanation for this cooling curve for the pure metal. And for example, you can write different pure metals are there. You can write iron, gold, your copper, silver. Number of examples are there. Any example you can put here, that will be the cooling curve for the pure metal. Okay, this is the first type of the cooling curve, that is the cooling curve for the pure metal. If you are having any difficulty in this point, you can ask me. And if you are not having any difficulty, we will move forward to the next type of the cooling curve. Let's confirm that. If you are having any difficulty or any questions, you can ask me.
तर ते रीजन बी टू सी चं एकदा रिपीट करू.
रीजन बी टू सी, ओके. आय विल रिपीट इट अगेन. फॉर रीजन बी टू सी, इन दिस रीजन बी टू सी दॅट प्युअर मेटल विल बी इन लिक्विड प्लस सॉलिड स्टेट, मीन्स टू फेजेस विल बी देअर. अँड वेन दॅट कर्व, सॉरी दॅट मेटल रिचेस ॲट पॉइंट बी, फ्रीझिंग विल स्टार्ट. And at point C, freezing will get completed. Here, this straight line is nothing but a single point. You are getting that? Here, time will pass, but temperature will remain constant. At that particular point, that metal will get transformed from liquid to the solid state when you are cooling that particular metal. Okay? Now, you have to apply the Gibbs phase rule for this region BC. Your Gibbs phase rule equation will be like this: P plus F is equal to C plus 1. That C value is 1, as here only one element is there. Then value of P will be 2, as here two phases are there, liquid plus solid phase. As to get solidified, it will take some time. It will be in the liquid plus solid state. That's why here value of the phase will be 2, that is P is equal to 2. Put that value, that equation, you will get the 2 plus F is equal to 1 plus 1. It means that you will get F is equal to 0. And as this F is equal to 0, it indicates that degree of freedom value is 0. Means it is a... As F value is equal to 0, it means that degree, it means that you cannot vary any parameter without changing the phase of the system. Here only one parameter we are varying, that is parameter is temperature. And if you change the temperature, suppose you have increased the temperature, then it will get transformed to the liquid state. And if suppose you have decreased the temperature, it will get transformed to the solid state. It means that F is equal to 0 means degree of freedom is 0. It is a non-variant or invariant system. Any change in the temperature will change the phase of the that particular system. Okay, so this is the explanation for region BC. Are you clear for this?
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, can I move towards next slide then?
Okay, continue. Okay. Okay, sir, continue.
Okay, okay. Please draw this curve also for your reference.
Sir, A to B is called as non-variant.
No, no. When F is equal to 1, it is univariant. When F is equal to 1, it is univariant. I will tell you, when F is equal to 0, it is invariant or non-variant. Means F is 0. When F is equal to 1, it is univariant. And when F is equal to 2, it is bivariant. Just you have to use the word for that value. 0 means non or invariant, like that. F means F is equal to 1. 1 means uni, like this. 2 means you have to take the word by, like that.
Okay, sir.
Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we will move towards the next type. The second type of the cooling curve is cooling curve for binary solid solution alloy. Okay. As this is binary solid solution alloy, from the word itself, it is clear that it is binary means value of C, that is the number of elements present, will be 2. as we have used the binary solid solution alloy, means in this solid solution alloy we are having two elements. Value of C will be 2 throughout the curve. In all region, value of C will be 2. Just the value of P will be different for each region. Okay, so this will be the curve. Please draw this curve. I will explain this curve. Now here at point A, it is in the liquid state. In the region A to B, that alloy will be in the liquid state only, means here value of P is 1. In the region A to B, it is in liquid state. When this alloy reaches at point B, freezing starts. At point B, freezing starts, and this freezing will get completed when it reaches at point C. And during this region BC, that alloy will be in liquid plus solid state, means for region BC, value of P is equal to 2. Now, from this curve, as this BC region is showing an inclined line, this binary solid solution alloy, it indicates that it will solidify over a range of temperature. Like metal, it does not solidify at a constant temperature. It requires some region, or it will solidify over a range of the temperatures. Means freezing will start at a particular temperature, and freezing will get completed at another temperature. Then during this region B to C, it will be in the liquid plus solid state, means the value of P will be equal to 2. Then when temperature drops below 0.3, it will get transformed to only a single phase. That phase will be the solid. In this region C to D, your alloy will be in solid state only, means your value of P will be equal to 1. Okay, now as you are clear about the first, while writing this description only, you will get the value of, as this this is a binary solid solution alloy, your value of C will be 2. Binary indicates that two elements are there. Value of C will be 2, and it will remain constant throughout. And just only value of the phases will get changed according to the regions. In this AB region, only one phase is there, that is the liquid. Then in the region BC, here liquid plus solid phase, two phases are present. And in region C to D, only one phase is present here, that is the solid. Now you have to apply Gibbs phase rule for these three different regions, that is AB region, BC region, and CD region. Okay, in the same fashion as we have previously discussed, you can apply the Gibbs phase rule here. I will repeat it again. For this first curve AB, or first region AB, first write the Gibbs phase rule. According to Gibbs phase rule, your equation will be P plus F is equal to C plus 1. Now, here you have to write the number of phases. Here only one phase is here, that is the liquid phase, means value of P is equal to 1 plus F, that you have to find out, equal to, here C value is 2, means two elements are here, 2 plus 1. Means you will get F is equal to 2. And F value is equal, F is equal to 2, it indicates that it is a bivariant system. As bivariant system means you can vary both parameters. We are having here two parameters, temperature and composition. As here we are having combination of two elements, composition may be different. Are you getting this? In the first curve, we are having the pure metal, and pure metal is having only one composition. That's why we have considered it as constant throughout. But whenever there are two or more elements, then composition will be different. Okay, composition will be, again you have to consider the variable, as you have considered temperature as a variable. Like temperature, the composition will be again a variable here. As here we are having two elements. Now in this region, F is equal to 2. It indicates that you can vary both parameters. That is, you can vary temperature as well as you can vary composition. In this region AB, there will be no change in the phase. It indicates F value is 2, means it indicates that whenever you are changing the temperature, or suppose you have changed the composition also, the phase will be liquid only. Okay, phase will be liquid only. That's why this F is equal to 2. It is a bivariant system. Temperature as well as composition can be varied without changing the phase in the system. Now, next region is BC. Region BC, apply Gibbs phase rule for this region BC. Here, your Gibbs phase rule equation will you have to write P plus F is equal to C plus 1. Next line, you have to write number of phases. Here, number of phases are 2. Liquid plus solid, two phases are here. Okay, p value is 2 here. Liquid and solid, two phases are here. It is 2 plus F is equal to, value of C is again 2, 2 plus 1. Here you will get F is equal to 1. As F is equal to 1, it indicates that you can vary only one parameter. Okay, we are having two parameters, temperature and composition. From these two parameters, you can vary only one parameter without changing the phase in system. If you vary both the parameters, phase will get changed. But if suppose you have varied only temperature, there will not be any change in the phase. And if suppose you have varied composition only by keeping temperature constant, then again there will be no change in the phase. Means it will remain in the liquid plus solid phase only. Means F is equal to 1. Here in the region BC, F is equal to 1. Means it is a univariant system. Means you can vary one parameter. Either you can vary temperature or you can vary composition without changing the phase in the system. Means that in the region BC, phase will be liquid plus solid only. Then we will move towards the next region, that is the CD. In this region, again, you have to apply the Gibbs phase rule. Here also, P plus F is equal to C plus 1. Number of phases will be here. Only one phase is there, that is the solid. Okay. Then you will get the value of F. Degree of freedom is equal to 2. As F is equal to 2, it is again a bivariant system. Means you can vary both temperature as well as composition without changing the phase present in the system. Okay, this is the overall explanation for this cooling curve for binary solid solution alloy. Now, this at the end, you have to write this one sentence here. In the region, this region BC, you are clearly seeing that here we are getting one inclined line. This inclined line indicates that binary solid solution alloys will get solidified over a range of temperature. It does not solidifies at a particular or fixed temperature. It will solidify over a range of the temperature. As you have seen in the first slide here, pure metal will solidify at a constant temperature. A particular point you will get here. At a constant temperature, it will get solidify. It is indicated by a straight line, but in case of this binary solid solution alloy, it will get solidified over a range of temperature. It is not having a fixed melting point. In other words, you can simply say that this binary solid solution alloy does not have a fixed melting point. It will get solidified over the range of a temperature. Okay, this is the second type. Now we will move towards the third type. Please draw this curve. If you are having any difficulty, you can ask me. I will wait for a few minutes. Please draw this curve.
Can you you repeat that sentence of that in the region BC, binary solid solution get solidified over the region?
Over a range. Okay, I will repeat it. In the region BC, as you can clearly see here, inclined line is there, means binary solid solution alloy solidifies over a range of temperature. That is binary solid solutions alloys does not have a fixed melting point. Okay, I will repeat it again. Binary solid solution alloys solidifies over a range of temperature. That is, binary solid solution alloy does not have a fixed melting point. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shall I move towards next slide?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is the third type. Now, this is the binary eutectic alloy. The curve will be similar as your pure metal cooling curve, but here phases will be different. Please draw the diagram. I will wait for 1 minute here. Please draw the diagram.
Hello, sir.
Ah, yes. You have completed it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And, if you are having any feedback, you can put that in the chat box. Or if you are having any query or any problem related this lecture, you can put in the chat box. Or you can have any query, you can directly ask me during the session also. Okay. Okay, I will start the explanation of this cooling curve. So this is the cooling curve for binary eutectic alloy. Now first you will get in mind that what is the difference between binary eutectic alloy and binary solid solution alloy. Okay. Now, in case of binary eutectic alloy, at the end, you will find the two different solids. Okay. Two elements will be there. Again, binary means two elements will be there. And at the end, they will show two different solids having different composition and different properties. But in case here, you can clearly see that at the end, you will get means liquid is transforming to two different solids here. Okay. That is the binary eutectic alloy. Liquid is giving you two different solids at the end. That is the binary eutectic alloy. And here in the binary solid solution alloy, liquid is transforming to a solid, single type of solid here you are getting. That is the only difference. Okay. And depending on that, they will be having different properties. Okay, are you getting the difference between binary solid solution alloy and binary eutectic alloy? binary solid solution alloy. Here they will be get here that liquid phase, from liquid phase they will get transformed to a single solid at the end. And in case of binary eutectic alloy, from liquid phase they will get solidify or transform to a mixture of two different solids. Okay, this is the difference between binary solid solution alloy and binary eutectic alloy. Okay, as here we are using the word binary, here two elements are present, means value of the C will be equal to 2 throughout the system. Okay, now I will explain the curve. From region A to B, alloy will be in the liquid state. Okay, one phase will be there, that is the liquid phase only. Now at point B, freezing will start. At point B, freezing will start, and simultaneously here two solids will start separating out. Okay, from this liquid phase, simultaneously, as here two different solids are there, means two elements are completely insoluble in each other. In case of binary solid solution alloy, there are two elements are there, but they are completely soluble in each other. That's why here you can clearly see that here they are completely soluble in each other. That's why whenever they are in liquid phase, one phase will be there, single liquid, and whenever they are in solid phase, single solid is there. And here, as these are completely insoluble in each other in the solid state, here we are having two different solids, and as they are completely soluble in the liquid state, only one liquid is there. And here when it temperature reaches at point B, freezing starts, and slowly two solids will start separating out from the liquid, means here phases will be like this, liquid plus two solids, two different solids will be there. They are trying to separate out from that liquid. That's why in this region BC, we will be having three phases, liquid plus two different solids. As two different solids are there, means they are completely insoluble in each other, they will show two different phases. Means in this region BC, we are having number of phases three, and when reaches temperature reaches at point C, and that solidification process will get completed, and below this point C up to point D, that alloy will be in the solid state. But as these two elements are completely insoluble in each other, they will show two different phases, that is indicated by S1 plus S2 mixture. Okay, two different phases will be there, and here you will get the P value is equal to 2. You have to consider it as two different phases. Okay, so this is the explanation of this curve. Again, this BC line is straight here, means it indicates that binary eutectic alloy will solidify at a constant temperature, or they are having a fixed melting point. Okay, again, you have to apply the Gibbs phase rule for three different regions. You have to apply the Gibbs phase rule. I think I have repeated it 5 to 6 times, how to apply that Gibbs phase rule, so that you can do it by your own. Just I will explain it in short manner. Just apply the Gibbs phase rule for this region AB. Here value of C, that is the number of element, is 2. Value of P is equal to 1. You will get the value of F is equal to 2. F is equal to 2, it indicates that you can means it is a bivariant system, and it indicates that you can vary both temperature and composition without changing the phase in the system. Means F is equal to 2, it is a bivariant system. And for region BC, here value of P is equal to 3, and number of elements will be 2. You will get the value of F is equal to 0. F is equal to 0, it indicates that degree of freedom is 0, means you cannot vary any parameter. You cannot vary temperature, nor you can, neither you can change the temperature, nor you can vary the composition of the system. If you vary it, phase change will occur. Okay, and during the region BC, then again in region CD, P is equal to 2. Here we are getting the mixture of two solids. Then number of elements, that is the C is equal to 2. You will get F is equal to 1. And this F equal to 1 means that it is a univariant system. You can change either temperature or composition without changing the phases in the system. Okay, that will be applied for the region CD. Okay, you can here take the example for, I will tell you some examples for this binary eutectic alloy. You can take the steel alloy. When it is in liquid state, only one phase will be there, that is the only one phase will be there, but when it is in solid phase, two different solids will be there, that is iron plus carbon. And sometimes iron plus carbon plus other alloying elements may be there. Okay, means it will give you two different phases when it is in the solid state, but when it is in liquid state, only one liquid, it will show only one liquid like this. For example, you can write the steel here. Then we will move towards the last type of this cooling curve, that is cooling curve for binary of eutectic alloy. Now, what is the binary of eutectic alloy? We have learned here in the previous slide. This is the binary eutectic alloy. Now, this eutectic alloy, particularly this binary eutectic alloy, means liquid giving a mixture of two solids. Here liquid will give mixture of two solids. It is having a particular composition, and if that particular binary eutectic alloy is having other composition than the eutectic composition, are you getting this point? Please clearly please concentrate on this. This binary eutectic alloy is having a particular composition value, and if there is another value other than this particular eutectic composition value, then that eutectic alloy will be termed as off eutectic alloy. Means it is having composition other than that eutectic composition, and it will give a curve like this, which is shown in this diagram. Okay, and whenever that composition, that other off eutectic composition is lesser, it is less than the eutectic composition, then it will be termed as hypoeutectic. And when that composition is more than that eutectic composition, it will be termed as hypereutectic composition, and that alloy will be termed as either hypoeutectic alloy or hypereutectic alloy. Clearly from the word itself, you can understand the meaning. Hypo means less. Whenever composition is less than that particular value, then it will be termed as hypoeutectic. And whenever composition is higher than that particular value, it will be termed as hypereutectic alloy. And that composition will be termed as hypoeutectic composition, and alloy will be termed as hypoeutectic alloy. In the same way, hypereutectic alloy and hypereutectic composition. Okay, in the here curve will be like this, and you can easily apply here. I'm not going to repeat it again and again. Here four different regions are here. Just I will explain the how the cooling will occur. Whatever part of that gives phase rule is there, you can do it by your own. We have repeated it again and again. Just I will tell you the how the cooling process will occur here. From A to B region, this alloy will be in the liquid phase only. When temperature reaches at point B, here freezing or solidification will start, and any one solid out of two. Here in the previous diagram, we have seen that both solids are separating out at the same time. But in this case, in the off eutectic alloy, only one solid, initially one solid will separate out, and after completion of that, in the next phase, when it reaches at point C, the second solid will separate out. Okay, in the first phase, one solid whose melting point temperature is higher, it will first solidify, and after that, when temperature falls, the second solid will separate out, and at the end, when temperature drops below this point D, you will get the mixture of two different solids, S1 plus S2. Okay. Now here again, this off-eutectic alloy, they will also solidify over a range of temperature from this region B, C, D. They are not having a fixed melting point here. Now for each region, you have to apply the Gibbs phase rule. That is, and you will get the value of degree of freedom, F is equal to 2, bivariant system. Means you can vary two parameters, temperature and composition, both you can vary. And in the region BC, F is equal to 1 means it is a univariant system. Means either you can vary temperature or you can vary the composition without changing the phase of the system. Then in the region CD, you will get F is equal to 0, means it is a invariant system or non-variant system. You can neither vary temperature nor the composition. It will result in the phase change. Then again, in the last region, that is D, that is F is equal to 1, it means the degree of freedom value is 1. Either you can vary temperature or composition without changing the phase of the system. Okay. In this way, you have to write the description and you have to apply the Gibbs phase rule for each region. Okay. In this way, we have completed different four types of the cooling curves. If you are having any difficulties, you can ask me. Okay, kindly, are you able to listen my voice?
Yes, sir.
If you are having any difficulty related to the type of cooling curves, please ask me and put your roll number in the chat box and please someone record that video of the chat box and send to me. Okay?
Yes, sir. Done.
Okay. If you are having any queries also, kindly let me know. Okay, in this way, in this lecture, we have completed what is the meaning of the cooling curve and what are the different types of the cooling curves. In that, we have seen learned the cooling curve for pure metal, then cooling curve for binary solid solution alloy, then cooling curve for binary eutectic alloy, and cooling curve for binary off eutectic alloy. And also, we have learned the concept of eutectic alloy. What is the meaning of eutectic alloy? And what is the meaning of off-eutectic alloy? In that off-eutectic alloy, we are having two types, a hypo-eutectic alloy and hyper-eutectic alloy. And we have learned what is the difference between hypo-eutectic and hyper-eutectic alloys. And in the next lecture, we will start the next point, that is the lever arm principle, that we are going to discuss in the next lecture. If you are having any queries, let me know. If you are having any queries, please tell me.